I just had the worst time. Two bad things happened to me. Number one, I got stuck in the middle of an update. Well, that's just going on forever. Infinity. And that took about an hour and a half to get through. I had bugs in the OBS. The OBS studio won't work. Then I looked at Pure Sim and had all the teams. Set the whole league up with all the teams, and it froze at updating imported statistics. That really bummed me out. I spent an hour, maybe hour and a half, setting it up, and froze up, gone. I don't know if it'll come back or not when I pull it back up. I'm just gonna play a game on this. I was gonna play a game of best of three or best of five with the two winners brackets teams. We'll try to get rid of this. Maybe when I bring it back, it'll have memorized it. I doubt it. I don't know. I think I might have done that once before with this game. 32-bit. That'd be nice if we could play. I got a game on Strat set up for it. We could play a game on Action, and I wanted to squeak in a game on Pure Sim. They've got all the teams from all the years back to 1875. That's pretty damn good. Plus, you can put in your own pictures of stadiums. And I don't think you can control the schedule, though. I was trying to figure out how to do that, and time was just slipping away. I thought I did, but it froze up. I wonder if it's going to remember. Okay, so I don't think I got to name it. Let's see. Load game. It's a 69 replay. Could this be it? 3/31/2018. All right. I think we're in. Be interesting to see how it turned out on this. So I figured we'll play one on each. Click to start the spring. You see, that's what I want to be able to do, is I want to be able to control the schedule. More association, system, edition, display options. I want to find some place where it says control schedule. I don't see it. This add custom manager, export custom, import custom. Now that's really nothing. Well, we'll go through a quick spring, I suppose. Well, let's go. Please make sure all team rosters are stocked and valid. Oh, come on now. You're not going to get all technical with me, are you? Okay, so I got every team, 1910 Athletics. Nineteen 11 Athletics, change their logo. That's good. And 1912 Red Sox. Yeah, that's good. See, the schedule is right here. That's the only thing about this game that I see that they need to work on. You should be able to edit the schedule. Maybe you can. I just don't know how to do it. stat leaders, pitching, fielding, miscellaneous reports, graphical rosters, injuries, highlights, export data, Sabermetric. Shoot, that would be cool if you could import the data from like the Stratomatic or something. It's not there. Manage the minors, manage my roster. Mama Tigers. So maybe I have to auto generate all this crap. Auto generate rotation. Kowaleski, Das, yeah, it's about normal. Auto generate lineup. First both. Okay. That's pretty good though. That's it. All right. That's it for the Tigers, but nothing on here about the schedule. How can we alter the schedule? I already looked at this. Hide schedule calendar logos. No, don't do that. Don't hide it. Where is it though? This game has speech, apparently, because I ran into some files. It was baseball speech. I didn't know. It must be for this game. Import schedule. Let's see. Schedules may only be imported at the start of the season before any game. I think maybe this would have been the way to do it. How did games get played? Okay, let's see. Please make sure all. Come on, man. Are you, let's see. Is there a way to just play? Scrimmage game. And set this up for every stinking team. Well, they got theirs done. Okay. Go to the next team. Boston Red Sox. Alright, so auto generate. I just want to play one damn game. I'm about to hang this up. This is going to get involved. Generate lineup. That must be for the White Sox. Okay. What's this? Schedule? Scheduling here? Maybe we can find a way to just have a game. Team 13 Athletics. Rosters and lineups. Auto generate lineup. First both. Auto generate rotation. Alright, what's the next team? 14 Boston Braves. It's going to take a few minutes. I'm sorry. You know, if it wouldn't have froze up, I would have had it done. I didn't think about remembering. Auto generate lineup. Press both. I guess I got to do this for every team, I suppose. Damn. Man, all I wanted to do was play a game. trying to remember what I'm supposed to. Oh, yeah. boy. I think I did it for the Tigers already. Let's see. That was a roster. Yeah. Close. Come on. 16 Boston Red Sox. Roster and lineup. Auto generate lineup for both. Auto generate rotation. I made it a 4-man rotation. But nope, they're giving me 5. They asked me 4 or 5 and I checked 4. I don't know. Alright, who's next? 17 White Sox. Auto-generate rotation. Auto-generate lineup. I did put a couple ballparks in here. You can send them a picture, import a picture, but you gotta put the right dimensions and shit in. They do have a few stadiums saved. Okay, set rotation size, yeah. 4-man. Whatever. Okay, so that's the White Sox out of the way. And that's 1918. Roster and lineup. Generate lineup first both. Generate rotation. Okay. Set rotation. I thought set rotation size. 4-man. One more team, I think. 2019 Cincinnati Reds. Auto-generate lineup. Auto-generate rotation. We got a 4-man rotation. Good. Okay. All right. Now let's try it again. Man, I gotta go through all this just to play one ball game. Can I just put it on 1912 Red Sox and say play ball? Oh, who are they playing right away? 1911? 12 is supposed to play 13. That's just stinks. No way to edit this, huh? I was really hoping to play a game on this. What is expanded team result? Okay. Team reports. Manager AI, GM tendencies, minor league, lineups, rotation. This is the last team right here, right? Okay. Let's auto-generate lineup first both. Auto-generate rotation. Now we should be able to be ready to play ball. So. Games. Don't give it to me. What do I gotta do? Please make sure all rosters are stocked. Oh, come on, man. You're killing me, dude. Can I just play a game that's, alright, I'll tell you what. Hold on one second. Options and utilities. Let's go back to main. Quick load. Unattended, play until they start spring. What's this? Players, can you just do a freaking game for God's sakes? ball game. Come on. Game. Play. Exhibition. Well, I guess we're not going to be able to use this until I get it figured out. I suppose every team's going to need 30 players. Some teams don't. Screw it. I've wasted enough time on it. We'll get right to it right here. It's going to take time to tediously figure out how many guys are on each team, who I have to add, or what rule I have to amend, because I'm not real good with that game. I just played it a few times. Okay, here we go. This is, we're going to do the best 2 out of 3 between the 1912 Red Sox. Oh man, I'm probably blasting. And the 1913 Philadelphia Athletics. Here's the games right here. Oh, guess what I did? I found last year. So I was right about the finals, but I was wrong and didn't go 7. It went 6. The 1913 A's won their first game against the 17 White Sox. Then they beat the 18 Red Sox. Then they shut out the 19 White Sox. And then they beat the 1910 A's. Now, the 1910 A's, I remember, they came through some heavy ass. They lost their first game, 3-1, to the Red Sox. I'm pointing at it like you can see. And then, after losing their first game, they came back all the way through. They beat the 19 Reds, 2-1. They beat the 11 A's, 2-0. The 1918 Red Sox, 3-something. Didn't write their scoring. Then they beat the 15 Tigers, 3-1. Then they beat the 1919 White Sox, 3-0. And they lost in 6 to the 19th. I played a best of 7 there. What I think I'm going to do for this one, then that's, they were the ones who won it. But this year it's different. And what I think I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to make the winner's bracket finals a best 2 out of 3. And we're going to probably, when we get to the championship of the losers, the game before, and I think from now on, I don't know. See, I wanted to keep it just double loss elimination strictly, but I keep thinking I want to play series because it's more baseball, for one, and for two, you know, you start getting into a team's depth, you find out how really good they are, and the teams are going to start getting to the bottom of their barrels after so many games, you know. So it's more of a, I think, it's more of a, shines a little bit more of a light on how deep they are, and that has a part of being how good they are. So, anyways, with that said, I'm going to make this 2 out of 3. 1912 Red Sox first. I was going to play 1 on each game, but now I don't know what I'm going to do. We'll just start the Strat-O-Matic and go from there. So, in this game, Boston is at home. It's a night game. May the 20th. It's Plank against O'Brien. Two good teams here.
And welcome to the stadium for today's ball game.
I just had an update. I had to go through it for about 2 hours. And now my screens are all smaller. It must have changed my display. Oh. Why didn't it just open up? It's always something. Well, I'm gonna quit this game. And we're gonna get back to it. So 1912 Boston, I gotta update the field. It's always something. update ballpark information. 32. Trying to remember. I was just last night. I think it's 39. Oh, for crying out loud. And I had that OBS error parsing X file. I had to figure that out too. Updates, they screw you up, I swear, every time. Now, what was I going to search? Oh, Brian's ballparks. Yeah. Brian's ballparks. What number is Fenway again? Of course, 1912, yeah, that was the first year. Number four. Number four. What am I going to do about this thing? It's not going to get 16 by 9. I'm going to have to change that to 4 by 3. Oh, there you go. Okay, that's better. Yeah, if everything can go 16 by 9, why not? That's the way it should have been in the first place. The writing's a little smaller, but I can still see it. Here we go. Scheduled game. Go through this again. Philadelphia, Boston. Wait a minute. I didn't check there. Make sure that they got Fenway. Yeah, they do. Okay. Scheduled. Philadelphia at Boston, and here we go. Plank against O'Brien. Yeah, it's not going to be in 16 by 9. Maybe. Let's hope so.
Welcome to the stadium for today's ball game.
Some people are anal. They can't stand it. I'm not. I'm an anal person's worst nightmare. All right, so this could get over. Thank you. That's okay. So this right here. Okay, the dice, I'm going to put them in. All right, here we go. We can actually, here's the play-by-play bar. Is that it right there? Oh, we'll find out. All right, here we go. Any stronger is better. And this is kind of good. I don't know what that is. That might be the play by play. Here comes the pitch to Stump from O'Brien. First pitch of the game, 5-8. That's O'Brien in third. Much better, isn't it? And I haven't even really tried to make it neat yet. It's just hanging there. But it gives me a lot more room to work with. 2-7. Maybe that update wasn't so bad. All right, there's one out. 1-1 Baker. He's leading the league in hitting. 1-4. That's a base hit. The center field. He's just swatting the ball all over the place. The runner of the bag. 6-10. Fly ball to center field. And he's going to make the catch on that. Play safe. If he tags up, goes to third. So much room. I don't know what to do. I'm on the show. Nice spacious park. And here comes Hooper. He's out. I think I'll move the cards down here. I'll get a whole new screen. Start watching that. Watching Stratomatic guys. That one guy's got a really nice screen. 1-6 K's. Man, I can't remember his name. Stratomatic photo set or something like that. He's got really, you know, he's got the mix. He went all out. There's a, it's gonna be a fly. Speaker flies out. He's hit the third. I hope you can hear me. I had an update, so that could have screwed everything up. I better turn this down. Looks like I'm. Am I coming all right? I don't want to be too loud, and I don't want to be too low. The levels look like they're about the same. Try that. Okay. Here we go again, you know. Hey, wait a minute. You know what? I remember last time I did something. Right here. Desktop boost. Mic boost. All right. Is that better? Yeah, I think it is. Okay. That was what helped me last time. All right, let's go here. Here comes Rube Oldring. We got a building that's top heavy over here. 2-9. Grounder is short. Yeah, he's out. All right, we're in the bottom of the, we're in the top of the second. There's one out. And the Athletics are batting. Boston's a big game for both teams. Base hit. Although it is going to be 2 out of 3. There's a man on first. There's one out. On the top of the second, Jack Rapp is the batter. 1-6. He walks. Both teams won all their games up till now. So somebody's going to get a loss. Eddie Plank, he delivers. Eddie tries to lay it down. It's popped up, caught by Gardner. Double play. They double him off. Here's Lewis. Base hit left field. So the hometown team gets a bottom of the second leadoff single. And here's Larry Gardner. He's got a round. Lewis is held closely by Plank, the lefty. That's going to be a line out. Eddie Plank, I think he's a lefty. Southpaw. 4-6, single. Base hit for Stahl. And that's going to be a man on first. And a man on third. Boston doing up. They got a little something going here. First and third. One out. Here is Wagner. And he moves away from Wagner. Throw this slide. Oh, watch his head. You're safe. Oh, man. Something happened there. I don't know what it was. There's the peg. Stahl slides to the outside. Avoids the tag. He's safe. Oh, he was a snap throw. No. Moves away from the bag. Inside slider. Wagner ducks down. And there goes Stahl. Okay, well, I guess he stole. I thought they were on second and third anyway. Must not have been. Okay. Second and third. That's going to be a base hit left field. Boston going to come through. Wagner delivers a big two-run single. Oldring threw the ball away for an error, and Wagner gets to third. That's a huge break. 2-0. 2-4. Ground ball to short. He's going to be out. It's 2-0. Scores the run. 3-0, Boston. That's a base hit. Oh, they've come to play. O'Brien. There's Harry Hooper stepping in. 1912 Boston Red Sox. I'm pulling for him. 5-9. He struck him out. The A's won it last year. Give someone else a chance. Here's Strunk. Of course, I won't feel that way with the Tigers. Grounder to third. Yeah, he's going to throw him off. Two and five. That's a triple, 1-5. It's gonna be an out. It's gonna be an out. So Philadelphia makes an out. It's the second out here in the top of the third inning. And home run Baker is up. He's leading the league in hitting right now. It's gonna be a home run. One. It's a home run. Oh man, everything else was a fly out. And he hits the one. Woo. Ones do happen. That's pretty good. One chance in 20 to hit a home run, and he does it. All right. Here's Eddie Collins. Home run Baker hits a home run. That's the first one I think I've ever seen him hit. 5-6. He led 1912. He led the league with 12 home runs. And I don't think any other player was close. You know, as it turned out, 12 wasn't crap. Babe Ruth, but... And He ended his career playing with Ruth. Home run Baker. He got signed by the Yankees. Of course. 1-7. Base hit. I was reading the story. And all right. We got first and second. And now Oldring is up. These guys were like journeymen. Gunslingers. 4-2. He walks. Ringers. Base is loaded. Jack Berry is up. And Philadelphia's coming right back. 3-1. First bases loaded. Two outs. 3-3. He hits a ground at a second, and they'll get out of it. Tight rope out of danger. All right, bottom of the third. It's 3-1. Steve Yerkes is the batter. Triple 1-3. He's gonna get the three and get the triple. Off the green monster. Rattle around, he'll get the three. And here's Tris Speaker. Red Sox have come to play, Philadelphia. 4-11. Fly ball right field X. Murphy is four out there. He can't get to much. That ball looked like it might be hard for him to get to. He's fooled. And Murphy's running after him. He picks it up. It's not necessarily two bagger. Well, club-footed Murphy couldn't get to it. And the Red Sox get that run right back. It's 4-1. There's Lewis. 4-11. I got a good crowd, don't I? Man, I went through some trial and errors, though, didn't I? Fly ball to right field, and he's out. Man, I got a nice lively crowd. That's what I wanted. All right, here's Gardner. 2-6. That's a fly ball to right field. He's at 4. Danny Murphy's. He's club-footed. And slides. Gardner's out. Nice catch by Eddie Murphy. Okay. I never know if it's going to be Eddie or the other guy. There goes the throw. It's high and safe. Steal number one for Lewis. So it's 5-1. One out. We're in the bottom of the third. Jake Stahl. 1-7. Ground ball to short. And he hit it hard. Right at him. It's going to get out. And that brings up Wagner. 1-for-1 with 2 RBIs. He had a big 2-run single earlier. He hits a double. That's going to bounce off the green monster and rattle around out there. 1912 Red Sox. Making some noise. And here is Kerrigan. Take that, Philadelphia. Take that. All right, 6-1. Crowd wants more. Pitch to Kerrigan. 6-12. Fly ball to center field. That's going to be caught. Ends the inning. They get out of it. After three complete, the score is 6-1. Boston. We're in control. We just have to glide now and get up one game to nothing. That's going to be a double 1-10. He's out. Fly out. There's Bush. This bullet Joe Bush. That is a triple 1-6. That's going to be an out. Hit it hard, but no dice. Amos Strump and his handsome away grays. And 3-6, base hit. Yeah, boy. I like Amos. All right, and here's Eddie Murphy. Swings a good bat. He hits it sharply, the first baseman. He's going to be out. Bottom of the fourth. 6-1. Bo Sox. He struck the pitcher out. It's all right, pitcher. Just pitch. There's Harry Hooper. Struck him out. It's a conspiracy. Here's Yurtz. Base hit. Yeah. Yurtz gets the base hit. Here's Trish Speaker. He's been in God. He's running. He's safe. Trish Speaker. Fly ball to right field. Right field. Question mark. Murphy's got club feet. I don't know. He pounds the mitt and takes it in. Has to be hit within 3 feet of him either way. The Red Sox. See how I spelled stocks? Just being silly. 1-10. Five. Eddie Collins. 6-8. And it's a pop out. That's going to be two down. O'Brien getting it done against these powerful Philadelphia Athletics. Triple 1-6. It's going to be an out. They get out of it again. Just keep shutting them down. Easier said than done. And here is Duffy Lewis. Triple 1-9. That's going to be a fly. He hit it hard and on a button, but Old Rain will make the catch. All right. Here comes Gardner. Larry Gardner is playing third base today. 4-6. Yep. I was reading Frank Baker's numbers. He had 1,800 hits. And only 92 career home runs. And they put him in the Hall of Fame in 1956. It's kind of questionable, really. And Stahl misses at the pitch, the throw. Head first slide, number two. He got it stolen, Gardner. Stahl. 4-10. That's a bouncer to third. And he's out. He's off the bag, not in time. He's safe. So Stahl will be there. Baker hit 309 lifetime. Not exactly Ty Cobb caliber. Stahl watches Bush carefully as he stretches out his lead. Wagner's the batter. First and third, one out. We're in the bottom of the fifth. That's going to be a triple, 1-4. That's going to be a triple for Wagner. Man, the Red Sox are on fire tonight. He's going to hit another one off that monster and rattle around. Gardner still clears the bases. Five RBIs on the day for Wagner. He's standing on his head. There's Kerrigan. Check him for steroids. 2-7. Ground ball to second base. Oh, I never seen him cheer for an out before. All right, three runs in. There's two outs. Oh, they got the run. That's one. Base hit, right field. It's not going to stop. 9-1, Boston. Tearing them a new one. That's a line out to second base. Harry Hooper's 0-4. Go figure. That's how it happens. All right. Here's Oldering. They got to get something going or they're just going to get run over. He struck him out. Everything's going Boston's way. It's Jack Berry. Triple 1-5. That's a triple. So he steps up and hits a triple. With one away. Here comes Jack Lapp. He's due. 5-6. Walks. First and third. Wasn't such a bad move. Here's Bush. He's going to lay it down. I'm going to try to squeeze here. Count goes to 1 and 2. Will they keep the bunt on? He gets the job done. Just moves to the second. His name is Strunk. Second and third. 2 down. Triple 1 to 6. It's a fly out. They're going to get out of it. How about that? They were threatening. They get out of it. And it's 9-1, bottom of the sixth. Yerkes is up. It's kind of going through the motions now. It's over. Six single. Boston's just not going to stop hitting. Bush is out there still. Grounder is short. Barry. Oh, man, that's a fly ball. It's no grounder. Looks like it's gone. Must be a foul ball. Here comes the pitch. Ground ball toward the middle. Shortstop. And in time. Baker has himself an infield hit. There's Lewis. 1-7. Struck him out. They're already way out in front. Whatever that means. 5-10. Fly ball to center field. Strunk. Strunk isn't drunk. He'll catch it. Breaking ball. Makes a catch. Two away. Here's Stahl. First and second. 2 down. Base hit. So Bush. And throw. He's out. Nope. Cut off. Yerkes is out at home. Yep. All right. Top of the seventh. Philadelphia is up. Here's Eddie Murphy. 2-11. That's a grounder to first. Hard ground ball. Sharp ground ball. He's out. Home run Baker. Base hit left field. The A's are getting taught a lesson tonight. There's Eddie Collins. He moves up 90 feet on the wild pitch. 5-8. Bouncer to third. Gardner from deep. Throws it. Got him. Okay, man on third. 2 outs. There's McGinnis. 1-5. Base hit. That'll knock the run in. And it's 9-2. Rue Bouldering. 2-2. Line out. Max. Boom. That was 2 outs in a row. All right. What are the weight requirements for a baseball? Oh, boy. I'm going to say 5 ounces. That's all I know, you know, for weight. 5 ounces. Right? Not less than 5 or more than 5 1/4. Okay. There you go. Baseball, typical baseball is 5 ounces. All right. Here we go. Bottom of the seventh. Nobody out. Wagner is up. He's been dangerous all day. He's going to line out this time, though. They got him. 3-for-3 with a triple and 5 ribbies, I'll say. There's Kerrigan. Struck him out. And here is Mr. O'Brien. He's 2-for-3. That's going to be a line out. And that's going to end the inning. Top of the eighth, 9-2 in this yawner. Boston put him away early. That's a triple 1-6. That's going to be a fly out. Philadelphia just can't seem to get anything going. He dives. He's got it. Oh, Harry Hilton makes a great play. Here's Jack Lapp. 2-9. That's a grounder to short. That'll be the second out of the inning. And it'll be up there against O'Brien. Davis pinch hitting. Struck him out. All right, John Taff is going to be pitching for the A's. We're in the bottom of the eighth. Harry Hooper's the batter. He's going to try to bunt for a hit. Well placed. And beats it out. Nice little idea. 3-for-4 for Steve Yerkes. 1-6. He'll strike him out this time, though. All right. And here's Tris Speaker. 2-for-4. He's having another godly day. Single 1-5. Oh, it's a line out. He hit it on a button. It's going to be right to the right fielder. And that is going to make two outs. Bottom of the eighth. Lewis is the batter. Man on first is Hooper. Runner to third, or short, and that'll end the inning. So here we go. Top of the ninth. This is it. 9-2. Boston leads. Not much of a game. Not what I expected it to be. 5-7. But usually, if a team wins the first game real big, you know what can happen. Score all their runs in one game. There's a walk. It's going to be a foul ball. Now he'll walk. Okay, there's a man on first. One out. Two to go. There's home run Baker. Triple, 1-5. That's going to be a fly out. Some high numbers. Boston got the low numbers. The A's didn't. Eddie Collins, it's all up to him. 2-12, hit by the pitch. First and second. And here comes Stuffy McGinnis. 2-4. Home run one. Everything else is a fly out. That's going to be a deep fly ball to right field, but Hooper is going to snag it right at the wall. It's gone! Hooper! 9-2. That's the ball game, folks. Okay, so on Strat-O-Matic, the Red Sox are the better team this time. Enter for 1912. Okay, I gotta see here. Okay, 12. B Sox. 9. 13. A's. 2. Okay. Okay, so 13 A's, 2, 12 Red Sox, 9. All right, there it is. A lot of big hitters on the Red Sox side for sure. Yerkes had 3 hits, 2 hits for Speaker. That's a pretty good lineup. Hooper, Yerkes, Speaker. Like I said before, I'm more impressed with the 1912 Red Sox than I am with the other two, three actually. 3-for-5 for Yerkes, 2-for-5 for Speaker, Lewis 2-for-5. Stahl 2-for-4. Wagner had a big day. 3-for-4, 2 run score, 5 ribbies, 6.25. 2-for-4 for O'Brien, so they all hit, even the pitcher. Baker had 3 hits, his usual game. But he's hitting 300 there. He was leading the league. Oh, but that's an action. Never mind. 9-2. The loss goes to Plank. He didn't do too well. O'Brien goes a distance and gets the win. We'll read the little synopsis here. Buck O'Brien pitched a complete game at Fenway Park, where 12 Boston Red Sox beat 13 Philadelphia Athletics 9-2. Heinie Wagner had a good evening at the plate. He laced a single, bringing home two base runners in the second inning, doubled, knocking in a run in the third, tripled, bringing in two base runners in the fifth. Boston managed 15 hits in their victory. The victory went to O'Brien, who went the distance, allowing two hits. Eddie Plank was given the loss. Knocked him around as he gave up six runs in 2 2/3 innings. Okay. All right, so that's one game to none. Now, man, I wish I could. I really wanted to do that Pearson thing, you know. I'm thinking I might try it one more time. I got this game ready to go. Let me just see if I can do a quick, like, exhibition game. Where's it at? Where's it at? Pearson, Pearson. Pearson Baseball. I got a lot of computer. I mean, I got a pretty big computer. I can run a lot of shit at once. Let's try new game. Is there anywhere in here? Pearson, fast, 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 draft. Draft with players from any year in the major league history using built-in Lehman database and true GM now to generate fictional universe. I just want to have one game. That's it. Let's see if I do a quick start. Is there just one game? Oh. Oh, you bugger. Okay, well. Let's try sandbox mode here. See what that does. Two teams. But I might want to. I had them all added. It's just not fair. We'll do it with four teams. Just to see. Okay. There's an association region. Boston. Philadelphia. Okay. And then, well, it doesn't matter what the team names are because you change them when you install the guys. It was pretty easy. Are you sure you want to overwrite the existing associated name? Oh, yeah. Okay, the Boston Smokies. Next. Okay, injuries possible. Injuries can occur. Expansion possible. No. Yeah. Use player photos if present. Sure, why not? Customized schedule, yeah. Ten games. Strict, what does that mean? Fatigue, okay. Do not use DH. We'll do four-man rotation. Development engine, true life. Import player historical stats. This option will import stats the player achieved in real life. You know, I don't see that as being a need because they'll have his. One thing I really like about this game is they've got the 1-100 ratings. Append source year to name to Williams. Sure. All right. Generate fictional players. Absolutely not. I think I can change that. Let's just go. Here we go. Real players and teams. Okay, now this was pretty easy here. I go to 1912. And Boston Red Sox. And then go down here. Boston. You can change the name right here. And then you import them. Yes. Takes a minute. It's not too bad. Okay. Boston seed 26 players. I gotta be cool with what I picked for the roster. So I don't want to have to be adding players. Then we got the 1913 Philadelphia Athletics. Yep. And bring them into Philadelphia. Report. There we go. Now we got two teams. Hopefully we can have a game. That's all I want to do is have one game. I was hoping to be able to do it for all of them, but that would take about an hour to set up. I can do it tomorrow. This game wasn't bad. I remember playing it with Ty Cobb and all that, 1915 season, remember that? It was like in December or January. 35 players, okay. Alright, I'll close that. Now we got the two teams. Boston. Change their logo. Won't take long. There we go. This is 1912, so I'm giving them that one. And then pick Philadelphia. Change their logo. Give them the elephant. Okay. So now we got to do the roster and lineup thing. So auto-generate lineup for both. Auto-generate rotation. Four-man rotation. Perfect. And I think there's not a... I don't see a save button. So we just close it. And then go to Boston. Roster and lineups. Auto-generate for both. Generate rotation, and they got a four-man rotation, and well, that's closed. Now let's go to a game. Oh, come on. Now what? All right, play ball. Come on. What is it now? I'm not going to make that mistake again. You should be able to just hit the game. That's the front office. Team reports, expanded results, schedule, calendar, ballpark. Okay, ballpark. Red Sox Smokies. Oh, I guess it does matter to change their name. Oh well. Team edit colors. Yeah. Don't hit that. Take you back to the beginning. What is it now? Continue to the next stage. Okay. Draft is optional. Would you like to run the draft? No. Okay. I don't know what this is. Okay, power rankings. Okay. All right, view today's schedule. All right, we're going to get to play. How about that? All right. So let's watch on the PSN cast. This should be interesting. So the starting lineup, Strunk, McGinnis, Baker, Oldring, Berry, Collins, Eddie Murphy, Lapp, Plank, and they got Yerk, Stahl, Speaker, Lewis, Wagner, Gardner, Hooper, a little different. And Collins. So Kerrigan and Collins. So here we go. I guess we just hit this
and the home of
Canadian.
The
Canadian.
Instructor.
All right. That's a fly ball. All right. You've got an announcer. No?
Now batting, Stuffy McInnes, 13.
I even had a picture of
now batting, home run Baker, 13.
You know, what is it? Shy Park. I even had that picture.
Now batting, Steve Yerkes, 12.
I can't stop it and put that in. Can I?
Now batting, Jake Stahl, 12.
Oh yeah, I remember this game. It sounds like there's a gunfight going on. No, nothing there.
Now batting, Try Speaker, 12.
Singles up the middle, pass the second base. All right, well.
Now batting, Duffy Lewis, 12.
Bouncer is short. Now if Boston wins, the series is over.
Now batting, Rube
Boldrink,
13.
For any of the third game, we'll go to action.
Now batting, Jack Berry, 13.
Little play.
Now batting, Eddie Collins, 13. Now batting, Heine Wagner, 12.
I can't make this one bigger.
Now batting, Larry Gardner, 12. Now batting, Harry Hooper, 12.
It's out.
Now batting, Bill Kerrigan, 12.
I think Plank pitched last game, didn't he? I should have watched that.
Now batting, Eddie Murphy, 13. Now batting, Jack Lapp, 13. Now batting, Eddie Plank, 13.
Speaker makes the grab.
Now batting, Amos Strunk, 13.
Draws a walk.
Now batting, Stuffy McInnes, 13.
This one's kind of loud. That's caught. I thought he had one.
Now batting, Ray Collins, 12.
I'll get the mic. I'll bring the mic closer to me. Because I don't know if you can hear me or not.
Now batting, Steve Yerkes, 12.
He struck him out.
Now batting, Jake Stahl, 12.
Top of the fourth.
Now batting, home run Baker, 13.
Struck him out. Collins pitching for Boston.
Now batting, Rube Boldrink, 13.
That's a fly ball, center field. Speaker has it.
Now batting, Jack Berry, 13.
That's a fly ball left field. It's, yeah, doubles.
Now batting, Collins. Eddie Collins, 13.
That's ripped into the corner, a gap. It's going to get a run in.
Now batting, Eddie Murphy, 13.
That's a shot right. Oh, it gets through.
Now batting, Jack Lapp, 13.
Yeah, he makes an error on the play.
Now batting, Eddie Plank, 13.
That's stroked. He caught it.
Now batting, Try Speaker, 12.
Just Speaker, he makes an out.
Now batting, Duffy Lewis 12.
Fly to center. He's out.
Now batting, Heinie Wagner 12.
He's out. Red Sox can't get anything going today.
Now batting, Amos Strunk 13.
That's a double. That's a triple.
Now batting, Stuffy McInnes 13.
Grounds into it. Now he's safe.
Now batting, home run Baker 13.
They got him at the plate. He's out. We threw him out at the plate. Yeah, man, third.
Now batting, Rube Oldring 13.
McInnes is on second. Oldring swings. That's deep. That's deep. It's a triple.
Now batting, Jack Berry 13.
Brown's out.
Now
three
batting, Larry Gardner 12.
He's out.
Now batting, Harry Hooper 12.
That's blasted. That's deep left, double. Hooper.
Now batting, Bill Kerrigan 12.
Needs to get something going here. They don't want to go to a game three. That's a monster fly ball. He's got it.
Now batting, Ray Collins 12.
It's a ground up.
Now batting, Eddie Collins 13.
And he singles.
Now batting, Eddie Murphy 13.
They threw Eddie out. They picked him off and threw him out.
Collins. Now batting, Jack Lapp 13.
Collins is on first and he just disappeared. They must have threw him out. Man on second.
Now batting, Eddie Plank 13.
Two outs. Pops it up. He's got to get over there. He doesn't. He singles. 4-0.
Now batting, Amos Strunk 13.
These A's are so good. Plank, yep. No,
now batting,
the bottom of six.
Steve Yerkes 12.
Asa.
Now batting, Jake Stahl 12.
Jake Stahl. Ryan's out.
Now batting, Tri Speaker 12.
That's scoped. First and second. This is their best
now
chance.
Now batting, Duffy Lewis 12.
Against Plank, who shouldn't be pitching. Oh, he flies out deep to right field. Yerkes goes to third. There's two
now
outs.
Now batting, Heinie Wagner 12.
Wagner needs some more of that magic. He makes an out. It's my fault.
Now batting, Stuffy McInnes 13.
I should make him take him out.
Now batting, home run Baker 13. Now batting, Rube Oldring 13.
Ball four. Take the risk.
Now batting, Jack Berry
13. Brian. Lines out.
Now batting, Larry Gardner 12.
Bottom of seven. He hit that a mile high. Caught it. Here's Harry.
Now batting, Harry Hooper 12.
Base hit. Nope. Good to sit down. Sit down.
Now batting, Bill Kerrigan 12.
That is caught. Deep right field. Stop the eighth. Four zip.
Now batting, Eddie Collins 13.
Track 3, you're up.
Now batting, Eddie Murphy 13.
All four, take your base.
Now batting, Jack Lapp 13.
Base hit.
Now batting, Eddie Plank 13. Now batting, Amos Strunk 13.
Struck him out. Bottom of the eighth. Boston's
now batting,
right here.
Caddy 12.
I should make him take him out. And he's pitched two games in a row. Although he did get his ass kicked last game. He shouldn't be allowed
now batting,
to pitch.
Steve Yerkes 12. Now batting, Jake Stahl 12.
But I guess I'll just have to take the blame for that.
Now batting, Try Speaker 12.
Could have swore their first pitcher said Chief Bender.
Now batting, Stuffy McInnes 13.
Top of the ninth. He's out.
Now batting, Home Run Baker 13.
He's out. Two down.
Now
four
batting,
zip.
Rube Oldring 13.
That's smashed. Triples to deep center field.
Now batting, Jack Berry 13.
It's a fly ball hit very well. He's got it at the wall. All right, this is it. Bottom
now
of the
batting,
ninth.
Duffy Lewis
Boston's
12.
Getting shut out. That's the first out. No. Oh, he gets a base hit. He doubles.
Now batting, Heinie Wagner 12.
Three,
stuck
out.
Him.
Now
no,
batting,
no five
Larry
RBIs
Gardner
today.
12.
That's a base hit. That'll score a run, 4-1. There's Harry Hooper.
Now batting, Harry Hooper 12.
Oh, he whiffs. Here's Kerrigan.
Now batting, Bill Kerrigan 12.
Laced left side, base hit. First and second, they don't want to die. Free run homer
now
here.
Batting, Clyde Engel 12.
Pops it up, and it's the ball game. Yep, Ray Collins gets the loss. He was a good pitcher, too. ESPN, cast, preview, quick sim. I don't know what that is. Okay, well, that makes it 1-1. So we're going to close this out. It was a little loud there, wasn't it? Woo. And we're going to get it on right here. I may have to augment the schedule. Yeah. Okay, well, that's not a big deal. Just go here to organize. We're going to go back to Boston. Schedule. Go to May 21st or 22nd. Yeah, 21st. And it will be 13 Philadelphia in a single game against 12 Boston. And this is it. Series is tied at 1-1. So the winner of this game will advance and be the champion of the winner's bracket. Yeah, all right, 21st. What? What is this shit? No, for some reason it didn't take. I don't know. Maybe I put it in the wrong day or something. Gotta go to May
21st. Okay. And 13 Philadelphia at 12 Boston. I thought I did this. Did I not save it? Okay. Now we play, and it's right there. Okay. Here we go. Twelve Boston, 13 Philadelphia. Back at Fenway. I do have a really nice picture of Fenway in the '40s. I think I'm gonna get it. This isn't bad, but I got a better one. Let's see. I don't know if it's better or not, to be honest with you. Is that it right there? That might be it. It's an old Fenway Park. I think we played there once before. Oh, I got another one too. I got a bunch of Fenways. Yeah, DB Fenway Park. It was Fenway Park 1. So we'll play at it. It's right here. Yeah, isn't that weird? Here we go. The Green Monster started out as a big sign with advertisements on it. All right. There's Collins. This is it. It's for all the marbles. As the A's lead off. Big outfield, it looks like. He's going to second. He's safe. To the third. He's safe. Base hit up the middle. Tough team. Wait a minute. Base hit. Hold on a second. O'Brien. Let me see. O'Brien can't pitch. Hold on. I did it again. Well, Bender's pitching for them. O'Brien, who's their best pitcher? Boston should be able to start their best pitch. Joe Wood. When he pitched. O'Brien is second in their rotation. Okay. All right. I guess he can go. I got to keep better track of the pitchers. Because I wasn't watching. All right. Well, maybe O'Brien will do what Plank did. Plank pitched like shit and then won. And O'Brien pitched like shit. Now maybe he'll win. But O'Brien got the win in game one. It's all right. You just have to make sure that in their next game they pitch their fourth pitcher. Both teams. Struck him out. Oh man, it's not looking good for Boston. You know, I told you, what I tell you, they scored all those runs in that first game, and I know it was three different games. Could have just went back to Strat-O-Matic. These guys haven't played on this game yet. At least I don't think Boston has, 1912. They're 2-0 in Strat-O-Matic. If I played the whole tournament on Strat-O-Matic, it would probably come out more true to life, I think. That's just me. Two outs to knock in another run. They're going to try to make a laugher out of this deciding game three here. Two outs, it's 4-0. Boston's got to get something going here. Man, Philadelphia is just... In this game and apparently the other one, they're unstoppable.
Dead ball!
That's down the line. Red Sox are in trouble. We got to get O'Brien out of there.
He's going to be out. There's Lewis. And they're just going to weakly pop the ball up. The A's are going to steal it again. Bouncer is short, long throw, he's out. If I'd have played it on Strat-O-Matic, the Red Sox would have had a better chance to win. Could go 4 out of 7. Or 3 out of 5. Oh, it's foul. Fly ball left field. He's got it. Fly ball to right. He's got it. All right. We gotta stop the bleeding and come back and start getting a couple of runs. 7-0. That's an out. Oh, base hit. That's gonna be 2. Don't need it? Yep. Okay. Fly ball to center, well hit. Got it. Oh. Bouncer to short. Gotta throw it. He's got him. Philadelphia came out roaring. I don't know how many times I've seen a 3-game series. It doesn't matter what venue. So we played it on 3 different venues. They come out, they score a bunch of runs the first game. Tigers did it too last year. And then they lie down and don't do nothing after that. But it ain't over yet. Still a ways to go yet. Boston can come back. That's a blast to center, way back. Oh, he's got it. 2 down.
Dead ball!
All right. Nice looking ballpark. Even when it was like this, it was nice. They had people sitting down there, and the big wall was behind them. That's a pop-up. He's out. That's a stroke. He's going for 2. He made it.
Strike 3!
Apparently, they got a lot of confidence in O'Brien. Nope, they just brought in Huck. Oh, wait a minute. Nope, the A's are out there. They took, crooked ball out, eh? The Hooks or whatever his name is. Chief Bender. Frank Baker. He's going to ground out. Red Sox got to do something. Got to start doing something like right away if they want to get back in this. 2 outs. Going to the second. He's going to be out. Bottom of the 6th. Fly ball to center field. Well hit. It's ranging over. He's got it. And that's an out. 2 down. Trish Speaker hits it right to the shortstop. And there's a base hit. And 13 Athletics look like they might repeat. That's a base hit. He's going to go to third. First and third. Get it in.
Track 3!
Struck him out. 2 down. Back up the middle. Nice play. Nice play. Duffy Lewis. It's a long fly to left field. It's caught. Honey Wagner. He had one good game. He's out. Bill Kerrigan back to the box. He's out. That's pretty feeble. They got 2 hits. He's out.
Paul Tip.
He hit him.
Oh,
Fly to center field, well hit. He's got it. That's a shot through the hole. First and third, two outs, top of the eighth. He pops it up, that'll end the inning, and they'll get out of it. Bottom of the eighth, 7-0. Two-hit shutout. For two pitchers. Bouncer to third, he's out. Two down. Matty Krug. Marty Krug. Man, at first, struck him out. Larry Gardner goes down. There's Walsh. It's a shot, rope foul. It's going to be out of play. That's a ball. Walking. To the second baseman. Second, back to first, double play. Yeah, I think we're going to go 3 out of 5 because it is an important, it's an important thing. Getting that winner's bracket. So I only have to win one game after that, and then they got it. That's a shot through the hole. He's coming to second. He's safe. Got the third hit. Trish Speaker pops it up. That's going to be the first out of the ninth inning. Duffy Lewis, bouncer to first. He's going to go over to first baseman. He's got him. Man, third, two outs. It's up to Wagner. He pops it up. This should be the ball game. And Oakland takes a 2-1 lead. Okay, 2-1. It's going to be the best of 5. Not because I want Boston to win, because it should be. Because we're going to do a real double loss elimination. This was the biggest series of the tournament. Because the team that sits in the driver's seat only has to win one more game. So, Philadelphia wins 7-0. Bender started, only went 4. Huck came in, resumed where he left off. O'Brien didn't pitch that well. That's it. All right, let's move over to Strat-O-Matic. It's 2-1. Philadelphia. And they're undefeated in this game. We can exit this now. And let's go over to Strat-O-Matic and get one more in. Okay. So, the game will be in Philadelphia. We'll give them home team. I'm going to have to control the pitchers so the same guys don't pitch again. Then we'll make it for, there was the first game. They played the 21st. That one now is 22nd. Add. Manual. 12 Boston. 13 Philadelphia. And we'll make it a day game. Okay. If the A's win this one, then they are the champs. Okay. Chief Bender can't start. So, they got a little problem here. Chief Bender just started last game. Well, they'll have to start, let's see, what is the best guy with the best record? Herb Pinnick? Shockey? Yeah, we'll have to start Shockey.
Mykoff? No, Shockey. He was a good pitcher. Okay. Wood is tired. He only got to pitch one game. O'Brien is tired, so they got to use either this guy, who was 20-9, 2.92. Holy smokes. Why didn't he pitch sooner? There's Ray Collins. He pitched. So we'll do Bendian. 20-9, 2.92. Select him. All right, here we go. This is it.
Welcome to the stadium for today's ball game.
The A's win this one, and they're the undisputed champions of the winner's bracket. Here we go. 2-12. He lines out. Harry Hooper. It's a little blurry. I stretched it. 2-3. Grounded to third. He's going to be out. Two down. I can live with a little blurry. Base hit center field. Just speaker. Here comes Danny Lewis. He's off to the races. He's safe. And he's going to be at third base. He threw it away. There's a walk. Here's Gardner. Larry Gardner. 6-1-5. Triple. Man, Boston likes this game. Two runs for the Red Sox. Here's Stahl. 2-6, base hit, center field. So Gardner will score. Stahl goes to first. Ground to third. Baker. It's two outs. Got him. Amos Strunk. Double 1-2. It's going to be a lineout. Or ground out, or whatever it is, fly out. Eddie Murphy. Home run 1-14. That's a long blast way back. And that ball is gone over the fence. Murphy. Clears the wall in right field. That's a base hit. He yanks that one on the right. Baker does. Here's Eddie Collins. Ground ball to first. That's going to be two. He's going to turn double play. Top of the second. 3-1. Boston. Runner to third. He's out. Harry Hooper is looking for a bat in the dugout. 4-9. He struck him out. Two down. 5-6. Base hit left field. Okay, so Hooper's on first. Here comes Steve Yerkes. Sure. Base hit. Yerkes singles. Hooper will go to third. Should. There's two outs. They're threatening again. They're up 3-1. They hit in this game. Shockey is holding them close. 5-3. Ground ball to first. Straight to three. So, no runs for Boston. It's 3-1. Bottom of the second. Stuffy. Line up to short. One down. Rue Bouldering. Grounder to third. He's going to be out. Two down.
Jack Berry. 4-6, struck him out. Top of the third, 3-1, Boston. Oakland leads, Philadelphia leads the series 2-1. That's a double. 1-6, now he's gonna fly out. Barry Gardner, 1-for-1 with a triple. Runner to second base. Shockey retires, first two batters in a row. Here's Stahl. Base hit, center field. Single for Jake Stahl. Strunk tosses it in. There's two outs, man on first. Third inning action. 3-3, 4-3. Fly ball to left field. Oldring is a one. It's dropping fast. Reaches up, makes the catch. All right, Boston is on top, 3-1. And here is Lapp. 3-5. Single. Man on first. It was Shockey. Ball for a ball. Bendy can't believe it. He won 20 games during the regular year. He's out by a whisker. Man on third. One down. Strunk. Boston wants to keep him. Single 1-8. That's a line out. Man, that's a big out. Can he tag? I don't know. Maybe. Nope. Just to the backstop. He's going to score. Kerrigan is crossed up on the pitch. Scored a pass ball on Kerrigan. He hurts him. He hurts him all the time. In this game, he pops it up. His weakness at catching. It's hurting the team. 3-2 now after three, top of the fourth. Philadelphia's right back in it. 6-8, struck him out. That Philadelphia team, man, they just, they don't have no quit, man. They just don't quit. 4-8. Ground ball to short. That's how they beat me. I had him beat. He came back from behind and beat me. 4-9, pops it up. That was the 1910 bunch, but they're just as good. 6-8. Pop up. One out, in the bottom of the fourth. Collins. Ground to first. E3, Collins to first. Throw. It was a dead duck. He got a little too greedy. You stuff him again. It's two outs. Single 1-8. That's a line out. Or a ground out. 3-2. Boston holding on to a one-run lead. That's a grounder to second base. He does it 360. I think it meant a 180. I loved my 180 spin throw from second. 2-6. Walk. I'm a lefty. I had to do that throw. It was really kind of easy. It's natural. Most teams don't like left-handed anything but first base and pitcher. 3-6. Man on first and second, one out. Larry Gardner. 6-8. Struck him out. Two down. Jake Stahl, 3-7. He walks. Bases are loaded. Uh-oh. Here's Wagner. He can do some damage here. Runner is short. It's all up to Barry. Can he handle that shot? He throws it. Got him. Nice play by Barry. Saved a run. Bottom of the fifth. There's Rube. Come on, Rube. That's a walk. Well, Bendient is doing pretty good. Going to second. Close play. Safe. Beat it out. Barry gets the job done. Oldering takes second. First and second. Here's Lapp. Ground ball to second base. He's got to handle that. And it's off the bag. Not in time. Bases are loaded. Here they come. 5-3. Fly ball to left field. There's nobody out. Lewis drops the ball. They get two and take the lead 4-3 in the bottom of the fifth. There's a bunt, fielded, he's out. 1-2, they get the run, they cut him down. One out, two outs, one. Late throw, no chance to get strunk. Second and third, one away, 5-10. Fly ball, center field. Speaker, he's got a good arm, he's a -4. He gets to just about everything. Strunk has a chance to move up. Strunk will hold, but he scores. And now he's dangerous in this situation. He's being put on to set up the force. Eddie Collins can hit. Yeah, it's a base hit. Man, Philadelphia. And slide to safe. And it rains the pours. They really needed Smokey Joe Wood for this game. Triple 1-6, that's an out. It's a fly out. That'll finally end the inning. 6-3. Philadelphia goes out in front. Top of the sixth. Boston in trouble being eliminated down the loser's bracket. Home run 1-2, that's going to be a flyout. They won their first game. Now they've lost two straight and on their way to three. Runner to short, he's out. Two down. And here's Harry. Unless Harry, somebody can step up and start doing something. Fly ball right field, he's out. Inning over. Bottom of six. Ball is short. It's going to be out. Ground ball to second. Can't come up with it. 3-4. Yerkes. They find a weakness. If you got a weakness, they'll find it. Force play. One away. Fielder's choice. Eddie Murphy's due up next. They put him on. There's Murphy. Ground ball to second base. That'll end the inning. Yerkes makes the play. So we're going to the top of the seventh. 6-3, Philadelphia. That's a base hit, 1-8, and he gets a base hit. Okay. Here comes Tris. K's. Duffy Lewis. Shockey's back. I'm going to dive in. That's triple 1-3. Oh, just misses a triple. He's going to fly out. Lewis. Two outs. 5. Ground ball to short. Barry has been solid all day. Can't come up with it. That's error number 2 of the day for 13 Pittsburgh. You're throwing, Aaron. First and second, two outs, little life here. Here's Jake Stahl, sitting 340. 3-8, that's a pop-up to first. That'll end the inning. Yeah, just when it looked like they had something going. When did John McGraw last appear as manager? Something just popped into my head, 1954. I have no idea if it's probably wrong, but that's my guess. All right, it's your year. Pick it, and here we go. At the 1933 All-Star Game, previously had retired from managing in 32. Wow, was I ever off. Jeez. Okay. Here's Baker. I thought he managed for like 50 years. Oh, that was McGillicuddy. 2-3. He's out. Connie Mack. Mack is short for McGillicuddy. Bendian. 6-6. I just learned that last year, so don't feel bad if you are. Left field, he's out. Two down. 3-12. Fouls out the catcher. That will end the seventh inning for Philadelphia. They have a three-run lead over the Red Sox. They haven't allowed a run since the first inning. And here is Wagner. They need to get something going now. Ground ball to first. That one had eyes. Good piece of hitting by Wagner. And on first. He's unable to get the lead that he wants. 5-6. Base hit one. Everything else is a line. Oops, sorry. I bumped the mic with my big old arm. And then it fell. Come on, Mike. It's top heavy. All right, one out. Grounded to short. Barry's been playing excellent all day. Turns to, of course. Bottom of the eighth. Red Sox are running out of outs. We'll go 4-7. Struck him out. No, I was just kidding. Just keep doing it until they win, you know. 5-9. All right, how about the 6-11. We won 32-50. I don't know. Okay, two outs, bottom of the eighth, and here is Lap. 5-5. Ground ball to short. Wagner. Over first is in time. After eight, complete. The score is 6-3. Here comes Boston. This is their last chance. They won game one, lost game two on Pure Sim, lost game three on action. And now it looks like if they don't do something here, they're going to lose game four on Strat-O-Matic again. So much for them being better on Strat-O-Matic. Base hit, though. They do play better. Man on first. There's Yerkes. Line out to first base. One down. Harry Hooper is on first. Here's Trish Speaker. He needs to really do something. Triple 1-7. Oh, he almost does. Damn. He draws a 9. That's going to be caught. Two away on the top of the ninth. This is going to be it. Lewis is the batter. Shockey's still out there. Struck him out. The ball game is over. Philadelphia wins the series 3-1. Well, they got every chance in the world. So they see they've played 3 games on this game. And the 13 Phillies have played 2. So, let's get this here. That would be 13 Philadelphia A's 6. Six, 12 Red Sox 3. Oh boy.
And there's the box score. I forgot to look at the hero because they always give it before. Hooper had a strong game. Yerkes did. Everybody had at least one hit except Kerrigan. And Murphy had two ribbies. Collins had one. They didn't really, I mean, the Red Sox out-hit them. They only had five hits, but they were extra base hits with men on base. That's what made the difference. Chalky pitched a great game. He gave up 10 hits, 3 runs, struck out 5. Bendient, 20-game winner, wasn't so fortunate, although he didn't pitch bad. 6 runs, 2 were earned. They made some errors. Gardner hit a triple. Eddie Murphy hit a home run over the fence. Gardner had 2 RBIs. Stahl, 1. Murphy, 2. Collins, his first. And Shockey. And it says here, Bob Shockey pitched a complete game. The Philadelphia Athletics of 1913 defeated the 1912 Boston Red Sox Stockings by a score of 6-3 at Shibe Park. 13 Philadelphia brought 4 runs across the plate in the bottom of the 5th, and that was the difference maker. Despite losing, 12 Boston out-hit Philadelphia 10-5. About 3 runs for the game. Hugh Bendient was hit with the loss. And that's it. So, we know the champions of the winner's bracket are the 1913 Philadelphia A's. So they win the series, best of 5, 3-1. They are now sitting pretty as the champions of the winner's bracket. Now they sit back and wait for everybody to play each other. I'll go right here. And loser, what is that, 18? It goes right there. They're guaranteed a game in the finals of the loser's bracket for going so far. And that's what they, so all these teams got to eliminate each other to get to them. And that's going to do it for me tonight. I played quite a bit of baseball today and yesterday. So nice bonanza. Had a nice couple days off. I'll try to get one more in for us to get my kids tomorrow, but you know, Thursday, got to get them. So we got games left here. Tomorrow, the 17 Sox will play the 14 Braves. The 16 Sox will play the 18 Sox. The 19 Reds will play the 14. No, that game's already been settled. The Reds won. So we have 1, 2, and then probably the winner of these two to play tomorrow. And then we'll get it on down and get it finished and move into the 1920s. Seems like it's going faster this year for some reason. Probably isn't, though. I got to make sure I save this. I almost had a disaster. My computer, I had to do a restart, and I fortunately saved a copy of this, or I would have lost it. Where are you at? Tournaments. Yeah. All right, that's saved. Then I went through the 2-hour update. That was fun. All right. Well, it's time for, it's past my bedtime. Have a good night, man. Thanks for watching. I always appreciate you. Without you, I wouldn't do it. So I'll see you. Have a good night. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.